Next news is out of the United Kingdom. A UK-registered Islamic charity has described Soleimani as a great martyr. So there were actually two charities in the UK that were doubled down on saying that Soleimani was a great martyr and a great man. And one even went as far as to say they hope that they get many more people like Qassim Soleimani to be born and live his legend. In front of the England Islamic Centre, they held a vigil, candlelight vigil.
Guys, I'm hearing something in the background. Somebody is touching their microphone. Be careful with that. All right, go.
Yeah, it's okay. So in front of the England Islamic Centre, they held a vigil, a candlelight vigil, to honor Soleimani as a great martyr. They said, "I also wish for highly esteemed martyrs to be given the highest positions, be showered with the mercy of God, and to be joined with the Master of Martyrs." So they've made these public statements. This is a tax relief and gift aid charity. So the charity of commissions in the UK said, "We're aware of the vigil held by the Islamic Center in England over the weekend and publications on its website. We're currently assessing information. We'll be contacting the charity to seek further information." So if people are wondering, they might say, well, they should have the right to do this and hold this vigil and everything else. Well, there are certain guidelines under charities of what you're allowed to honor and what you're not. So you can't honor someone who is a known terrorist, right? You can't honor something that is bad for a community that you're serving. So they do have the right to research this, in my opinion. What do you guys think?
Are these Shia charity groups? Or they must be.
That's a good question. I don't know if the Islamic Center of England is Shia.
Because this guy is a Sunni killer. Like, so it would be bizarre to me if a Sunni Islamic group was praising him as a martyr. They said,
if anyone wants to know the second group, sorry, Armin, didn't mean to cut you off. It's the Islamic Human Rights Commission. These are the two groups that are speaking fondly of Soleimani.
In their statement, they said the Master of Martyrs. Is that what they said?
That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they must be referring to Imam Hussein, which is a Shia thing to do. They must be Shia. If can tell me, guys, if they're not, by the way, anybody, it's not just Muslims that are like Shia Muslims that think that this guy is a hero. There's a whole bunch of leftists and again, hashtag not all leftists in America that think this guy is a hero, or I don't know, in the UK as well. Like, I think a whole bunch of people have gone so extreme with their anti colonial, like Western colonialism, that anything that has stood against it must be a good thing. There must be a good thing. So this guy is like kind of a hero to them because he stood up against America, and they keep saying, oh, he attacked ISIS, he killed ISIS, so he must be a good guy. Like, he, oh, like, you guys, you think this guy was a terrorist? He fought against ISIS. But I keep reminding people, you know who else fought against ISIS? Al-Qaeda. All right.
Exactly.
So are we going to like praise Al-Qaeda for fighting ISIS? But again, there is these people, Soleimani and all his proxies, he didn't just fight ISIS. He fought Sunnis, right? All Sunnis. And, you know, with the like vague accusations of being ISIS sympathizers. Like, these people are against Al-Qaeda and ISIS, not just because they're Al-Qaeda and ISIS, but because they're also Sunni, right? So these people, when they, their proxy militia groups, when they go in and they defeat, like, ISIS, right after they defeat the ISIS military, they will go around and burn around houses of civilian Sunni people and kill a whole bunch of Sunnis with no trial, like kangaroo trials, like accusations of your ISIS. Like, if you look at their videos, right, of the militias when they were like bombing ISIS territories and stuff, if you look at like what they wrote on the missiles or what they prayed before the battle or the songs that they sung, they weren't anti-ISIS songs. They weren't anti-Al-Qaeda songs or say. They were anti-Sunni songs or chants, right? So these people want to wipe out Sunniism everywhere they go. They do demographic engineering. They like wipe out the houses of Sunnis, try to bring Shias in there. These people are terrorists. This guy is responsible for another proxy group in Afghanistan, Fatimiyun, which brought more than 5,000 child soldiers from Afghanistan. Way more than 5,000. 5,000 is the number one children that died, right? Afghan child soldiers fighting for Iran in Syria and Iraq. You know how crazy? Like, it's not even the war, they're children, and they're dying for this guy to fight for a country that they don't even belong to. And they call this guy a hero. And these are, by the way, these are Muslims that this guy is killing. And other Muslims are praising him. Like, imagine how stupid that is. And you know why a lot of leftists, again, hashtag not all, think like, oh, Shias are not terrorists, but Sunnis are terrorists. Like, they're like, why are we accusing Shias of being terrorists? It's the Sunnis that did 9/11. It's the Sunnis that are ISIS. It's the Sunnis that did this. It's the Sunnis that did that. Because in all their examples, they only mention the attacks on Westerners, right? Because apparently, terrorist attacks on people in the Middle East don't count as terrorist attack. So they're thinking like they're being pro-brown people or pro-Middle Eastern, but they don't recognize that the only terrorist attack that comes to their mind are the ones that are on the West. Because yes, Shias actually have more terrorists than Sunnis, but most of their terrorist attacks are in the Middle East. But apparently that doesn't matter because human lives don't count if they're not happening in Western countries. Anyways, that was my rant.
I think that's a really good point, though, that you made, that people are unaware of what's happening in the Middle East. They only see it to their own worldview. But also, I noticed, like, a lot of the Westerners who were saying, you know, how great Soleimani was, or maybe it wasn't, you know, maybe he wasn't so great, but Trump's the real terrorist. Like, from my perspective, that's what I'm seeing is, you know, people maybe don't 100% disagree with the action, but they disagree with it because Trump did it.
Absolutely.
That's the main focus, that anything he does has got to be bad because it's him. And so, therefore, Soleimani has to be a decent guy because Trump's the real terrorist, which is what people were telling me. Also, you know, I've heard people say things like, oh, you know, we don't know that that's really true. And for example, in this Islamic Commission on Human Rights chair and some other people were saying, or maybe it was the ICE spokesman, that it was the ICE spokesman, the Islamic Center of England, said that Soleimani, you know, being a killer, all the stories about him, it's all propaganda. It's not true.
Wow.
And it's just mere propaganda is what they said.
And these are the people that didn't know who this guy is until a few days ago. And now
right. And that was the ICE spokesman in England. But yeah, the guy who was doing the thing. But yeah, a lot of these Westerners, these leftists, not all, that I speak to, didn't know who he was. And I asked them.
We've been seeing that in our groups as well. We've been seeing a lot of people who just have been apologizing to everyone in Iran for Trump taking down someone that they held in high esteem, not knowing who Soleimani was, not really researching anything about him, just Trump bad, therefore Soleimani was good, and we should all be apologizing down on our knees. And it's been really strange.
Michael Moore wrote a letter, supposedly, to Khamenei, but which it's kind of grovelly. Also, I was just thinking that you commented, you know, people are so anti-colonialism. But again, these are people that slept through history class. They only see colonialism in terms of Western colonialism. They don't see Islamic colonialism. They don't see what happened in Africa when Islam came in, or what happened to other people in different regions. The Mughals, for example, coming into India. So all colonialism is Western. It's white. It's bad.
Right.
Everybody else has to, by nature of the West, white being bad, they're all good.
And actually, you don't even need a history class to ignore different kinds of colonialism, because right now, Iran is doing colonialism by taking control over Iraq's government, right? So
good point.
This is like empire building, British Empire meddling, and United States. What is the United States doing in Iraq? It's none of our business. Okay, good question. Here's another question. What the hell is Iran doing in Iraq? It's not their question. It's not their country either. What is Iran doing in Iraq? In fact, Iran is doing way more meddling in Iraq than United States, because United States what is United States doing in Iraq? They have like some army groups with the permission of Iraqi government, but what is Iran doing in Iraq? They're picking the politicians. They're like, nope, this guy can't be a politician here. This guy is not loyal to us. This guy is a politician. This guy is like connected to us for the past 40 years. This guy is going to be a head of your military. This guy is going to be this. And, you know, Iraq is like, can we pick our own government, please? Can you guys get the hell out of there? They're so hypocritical, because they like these people that, I mean, I don't make excuses for United States meddling. I criticize it as well, but at least I'm consistent. I also criticize Iran's meddling in their neighboring countries. And, you know, Iran's meddling in other people's in the countries around it is actually a lot more menacing than the United States. In fact, it would be even more menacing if it had the same power and military might that the United States has. Imagine how devastating Iran's influence has been in the region, and now imagine that plus the military might of the United States. Imagine how much worse that would have been. But again, who cares? Because if you're so anti-America, and you know the most interesting thing is that the most anti-Americanism that I see comes from Americans. They're so...
The left. Yeah, Americans on the left.
Yeah, so self... You know, it's the same thing as the so patriotic nationalists being on the right that think, like, America is just the best thing ever and everything great that has happened around the world is because of America. These people are exactly like that, because now these people on the left think everything that has happened that is a problem in the world must be because of America. There's nothing that happens that people... There's no suffering in the world that happens that is not fault of... They're both just so centered on themselves. They both just think so highly of themselves that the world evolves around them. It's just a different side of the same coin. One side thinks everything great happens because of America. The other side thinks everything bad happens because of America.
I'm so glad that you said that.
Because other people have no agency. But go on, sorry.
No, I was going to say, I'm so glad that you said that, because I've been saying this narcissistic navel-gazing on the right and the left centers America in everything. Everybody else are just savage children waiting to be enacted upon by America. They have no agency. They can't make any decisions about their own country. They take any action. It's all because of us. And you saying that it's the two sides of the same coin, it's true, because if you have one side that has this, we're number one, we're the best, tends to be, you know, more of the right, and then this, we're number one at being the worst of the left, you know? So really, it's the same thing. Right. They still think everything's about us, and we're still the best. Because we're the best at being the worst.
Right, exactly.
You know?
Mars in the left is saying the right treats America like the child that can't do anything wrong. The left treats America like the child that can't do anything right. Anyways, we spoke.
Very good.
Shopam Ali, did you want to add anything?
No.
Okay.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we are doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.